New South Wales plans to trial 7-day home quarantine for international travellers has fuelled hopes that Aussies may finally return to the skies and head overseas in December. But if you still think there's a flight of fancy, you're not alone.
To answer all of our travel questions, we have Chris Zeiher from Lonely Planet joining us from Melbourne this morning. Chris, first of all, are we really going to be travelling overseas by Christmas? We've got our fingers crossed.
I know. Fingers, legs, toes, all of that sort of stuff. It's the million-dollar question, and there's a couple of barriers still in our way, but I am feeling pretty optimistic. So the first thing that we've got to recognise is the international borders are actually currently still closed. So, and that won't actually change until the 17th of December, and there is no guarantee that we're actually going to be travelling overseas by that time or that it could be extended. The second big thing is the returns cap on returning Australian travellers. That does need to be removed for us to be able to have some hope here. That will only be removed at an 80% double dose vaccinated for eligible Australians. And so therefore they're the two things in our way. But if the trajectory is looking like it should with that 80%, that potentially means that 18th, 19th of December is looking pretty sharp for us to travel overseas. And where we'll be going is the next really interesting question, I think. And that's when we have to look at Qantas and we have to look at where the routes that they've actually announced that they're taking bookings for from the 18th of December. So it's likely that we can get to places like the United Kingdom, the US, Singapore, Canada, and that return route through to New Zealand. So that's incredibly exciting for people that want to go overseas and see loved ones, hopefully at the festive season.
Now, we won't have to quarantine, presumably we're ever allowed out of our own country. We won't have to quarantine when we go to any of those countries, but we'll still have to quarantine when we get back, right?
Yeah, so it's super interesting. Each one of the rules of admission to different countries is actually slightly different. So I'll use the United Kingdom as an example. So if you're going to the UK, you need to have a proof of a negative test 72 hours before you depart. On arrival, 2 days later, at your own expense, you'll have to have another test. And then you also have to fill in some form of a commuter log, which actually tracks your movements when you're actually there. If you're going to Canada, you'll only be admitted on approval of the approved vaccine, and you have to be fully vaccinated. The vaccines in Australia are on their approved list. So each country has a slightly different set of regulations. The other big question is what happens when we return home. Hotel quarantine should be abolished by that stage and there will be some form of mandatory home quarantine. How long that's for, we're not 100% sure. And it will probably change over time. So it might go from 7 days to 5 days to 3 days to being abolished by the end of 2022. Who knows?
What do we know about travel insurance? Will we be carrying the risk of things falling through and an outbreak of the destination and that sort of thing?
Yeah, that's a really tricky space. So a lot of travel insurers are actually offering a COVID-19 policy. And when it comes to travel insurance, I don't think there are any dumb questions. You should ask as many questions as possible to know what you're actually buying. So one of the key things that you need to ask here is if you're overseas and your traveling companion or a family member does get COVID, and you have to extend that trip, is your policy then extended with you? So you do need to get, devil is in the detail, right, with these things. You really, really need to drill hard into the policy's terms and conditions and ask as many questions as you can of that insurer to kind of understand what you're actually purchasing.
Okay, just imagine for a minute we're on an international flight. We're on a 20-hour flight to somewhere fabulous. I've got a few questions. Do you have to wear masks the entire time you're on that 20-hour flight? Will there be food and beverage? Will the whole aircraft be full? What's it going to be like once we're actually out and in the sky?
So the best thing for us to do is look at what's going on in the Northern Hemisphere at the moment, because they're actually flying internationally and have been flying for a couple of months now. Planes look fairly much full. Masks are mandatory. And one of the interesting things is a lot of airlines aren't allowing fabric masks. So you just also need to understand what you need to bring on board. So we need to get comfortable with our travel kit is going to be slightly different. So you might have your daggy neck pillow, right, and your padded eye mask, but you're also going to have a face mask as well. You're still going to have meal services and drinks and all those other bits and pieces, but it is going to look slightly different. We're going to be a little bit more covered up than normal. And, you know, we're just going to have to kind of get used to that.
You mentioned that quarantine in Australia might be around until the end of 2022. Who on earth is going to be able to factor in that amount of time for a holiday to be able to quarantine when they get home? And you can forget about people coming from overseas. Is the tourism industry really up for another year of decimation?
No, is the short answer to that. And this is where rapid testing has to be part of the solution on arrival. And I think if we look at what the UK is doing, they're a really good blueprint for what Australia should be thinking about doing. If we're looking at destinations where we're allowing arrivals to come in, if we're asking them to take a test 2 days within arrival or a rapid test on arrival, surely that is a better way of actually making sure that we can have a freedom of movement and just get some money back into our tourism sector. It employs so many Australians, so many passionate Australians that do such a unique thing and show Australia off to the world. We're such a pristine destination that's so desired by so many people to come to. We really want to start to open up again and showcase the beauty of Australia to the world, right?
Yeah,
right.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Goes both ways. Well, you can get more travel info on inspo at lonelyplanet.com. Chris Eyre, it's always a pleasure. Nice to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Cheers, guys.